With Maskarad, you can easily transfer performance capture data to your own character rig. This video will explain how to import Maskarad's motion capture file and apply its data to this 3D head using standard motion retargeting tools in 3ds Max. This head has been set up with a morpher modifier and has a series of predefined morph targets to control the eyebrows and the mouth. Let's click File, Import, then simply select an FBX file to import in our scene. When importing an FBX file, there are two options we want to be sure are properly set up in the FBX import dialog. Firstly, the file content needs to be set to Add to Scene. The other important setting is the unit size, which should be set to match the size of your scene's content. In this case, I will set it to decimeters and click OK. Now that the data has loaded, if we look at our scene, we now have two heads. Our original head with all of its morph targets, and the head imported from Maskarad. This new head object has a wealth of animated morph targets, but as you have noticed, is not being deformed. What we need to do is to take the animation curves from the Maskarad head and apply them to our character's head. To do so, we will use the graph editor and some advanced copy and paste functions of 3ds Max. The first thing we will do is to transfer the head motion. So from our head here, I will select this bone, and I will go in the animation menu, then choose rotation controllers, then orientation constraints. Then I will set the constraint to the head transformation object supplied by Maskarad. This transferred the head rotations to our head without transferring the positioning. What we want to do next is to transfer the animation curves from the morpher of our object to the head. So let's open the curve editor. In the curve editor, if I browse through, we can see all of the animation curves that have been exported by Maskarad. What I will do now is simply select the lips opening, so the animation curve for the exported lips opening. Right click and choose copy. I can then select our character's head and go to the equivalent morph target, which is the mouth A here, right click and choose paste, making sure to paste it as an instance and replace all instances. Pasting this as an instance will take the animation from our object and paste it to the mouth A channel of our head. When this is done, scrubbing the timeline, you will see that our character is starting to have some lips motion. What we can do, since the lips values go from 0 to 30 or 35, is apply a curve multiplier. So with the mouth A curve selected, we will go to Curves and select Multiplier Curves. This has just created this multiplier curve here. With this curve, we have the ability to adjust the intensity of the animation curve very easily, like this. And now my animation of the mouth opening goes from 0 to around 100. Looking back at the results on our character so far, we have successfully transferred the head motion and the mouth opening from the motion capture performance data. Next, using the exact same technique, we will transfer the eyebrows motion. So I select the head object, open the curve editor, then select the eyebrows frown curve, copy it, then select our character's head, pick the brow frown curve, and again paste the curve as an instance while replacing all instances. If we look at our animation now, we can see that we now have some eyebrow motion just with that one target. We can easily apply multiple other curves, and the result will get better and better the more curves we copy and paste. When all of them are set up, with or without multiplier curves, you will have all of the animation transferred. 3ds Max provides us with a wealth of tools to tweak the results to our liking, and we would be hard-pressed not to use them. Amongst these tools is the Reduce Key tool. As you can see, with a value of 2, we have reduced the amount of keyframes quite significantly. And with a really high value of, let's say, 5, we could really keep our keyframes to a bare minimum, if that's what we want. So basically, the Reduce Key tool will help us with keyframe reduction to smooth out our animation. Keep in mind that what we are looking at right now is simply the head rotation, mouth opening, and frown of our animation. Only a fraction of what Maskarad records from the actor's performance. A really cool advantage of using the FBX pipeline in 3ds Max is that when you have this setup completed, you can easily just do File, Import, and import a new FBX file that was exported from Maskarad with a completely different animation. When you select this file, you need to pay attention to the two same settings as the first file you imported. But this time, instead of adding it to the scene, you want to choose Update Scene. What this will do is it will only load the animation data, while keeping your rig and setup intact in your scene. As you can see, we have a brand new animation taken from this new FBX file, automatically working with our scene. We still have the multiplier curve, but with completely different animation curves. Thank you for watching this quick overview on how to use 3ds Max to achieve motion retargeting on a head rigged with morph targets, using data provided by Maskarad. Come visit our website and download the trial version at www.di-o-matic.com.